Hi everybody, my name is Jessica Holyfield. I'm a professional dancer, professional dance choreographer, and dance educator based out of the southeast of the US. And today, we're gonna be taking a look at YGX's Yeoljin versus Waybee's Nolzae's battle from the first season of Street Woman Fighter. Now, I am pretty excited about seeing this. I have not seen any of these battles, nor know who has won any of these. So it'll be kind of fun. I'm gonna be not only analyzing, but picking who I thought took the battle. So let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, he's gonna go first. Let's see. Looks like Yeoljin. Nice base. Hip, shoulders. Good attack so far. It's good that she made that texture shift there. There's a good chance she probably doesn't know the song. Or she thought it was a different part. Okay, I mean, she did have she didn't really vary herself around other people. Sounds like we don't have the audio for this one. Man, we're gonna take a look at her movement quality anyway, though. I really like what she's got setting up for her, though. Ooh, okay. I like her different shifts of technique for sure. Ooh, that was grimy. Well, I will say though, I kind of feel like she kind of should have just let her finish, maybe. I wonder if that worked kind of against her. I don't know. Interesting. Okay, so we saw that one of them did not have audio. I mean, of course she danced to audio, but we couldn't hear it. So I'm gonna analyze them both with no audio just to kind of make my guess off of that, just to be a little fair. Okay, so starting out, I will say Yeoljin, she had a pretty good setup in the very beginning, you know, but I will say she started to repeat a lot, starting to hit very similar bases throughout the entire thing. So that's gonna be my big note for her. Like the setup was really cool when she was hitting here, and then it's just boom, boom, and then look, she watches, she does her shoulder there with the chest, boom, there's the shoulder, and she does that again later on as well. Yep, and then she does this little intimidation check. I mean, it's fine. But I kind of feel like, well, this is also why I'm watching this during the second season, is because some of these things I feel like we kind of see instances of in both seasons. She is dancing, not dancing, but I feel like she's taking breaks really similarly to how Red Alique did during episode 1 of season 2. So yeah, but notice like she's kind of reverting back to, she's repeating the ticking here. And then from there, you know, she's locking contact with her the entire time. Can that work for you? Yes, sometimes. But also, I will say though, I really feel like she could have kind of danced around, not really so poignantly looking at her this whole time. Not sure, but I don't know. That's my note. I kind of feel like, you know, it was kind of, she's trying to figure out what she's gonna do, and then she's, you know, dropping down again. She did the shoulder again. So I feel like that's gonna be the biggest thing if out of my toss, like I think it's like a low key toss up, but I would say that really worked against her here. You know, keeping contact when she comes up and then she stops to just look at her. I think she did that a time too many, personally. Okay, now we're gonna look at Nolzae. I don't know if it's Nose or Nolzae. Please correct me in the comments so I know moving forward I do not make that mistake. Okay, so she is starting it up. She's establishing what range she wants to go in. I love that little mess right there she just did. She kind of ticked through it, which I really liked. And then, you know, she starts to involve the body more, getting her legs involved more. Her arms too, but she is kind of keeping it pretty ambidextrous on both sides, which can work against you as well. So that's just my little note there for her. I really like that, how she tried to, you know, trace up and do something there, which was fun. And I love the switching of the feet. Super cool. I don't know how her musicality is riding with the music right now for obvious reasons, but I'm just gonna assume that they're riding it the same way. With the turn, I like it. So I will say she has with grooves. She's keeping this like sumo squat kind of pocket with how she's choosing to do stuff. Now I think it was pretty even until this started happening. So what ended up happening is she's trying to do a bit more like being intimidating, but what's happening is she's just still repeating movement, which is truly showing her limitations as a freestyler. You know, she's really, because she is shorter too, I don't know if like there's I don't know if there was an issue with height or anything. I know in an episode last in season two that I had watched recently, that was a thing that was brought up in the dance, which was, you know, height, right? So I don't know. But just kind of looking here, I just feel like I think that was a bit unnecessary for the battle, in my honest opinion. Now if I were to pick between the two, my vote would be Nozze, surprisingly, because I didn't even hear her music. But the reason is I just saw more variety, and she didn't really repeat too much. And that, I think, was the biggest downfall of Yuljin. She also didn't really allow Nozze to actually finish her entire thing. I think that did throw her off just a little bit too, just having her get so close. So I wonder, with those two things, like for me, if I was judging, I would probably award the win to Nozze. So, but yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm excited to continue diving in through all of these battles. There's so many, but all of them are just, I'm just looking forward to each and every one of them, which is really cool. I'm excited for the discussion on this one and the comments, and I will check you later. Bye.